Hello and welcome to the Simplifiers Podcast. And today's bonus episode is another one of my super thoughts of the day. It's here to spark new ideas, new ways of thinking, new inspiration, and simply to challenge old beliefs you might have so you can evolve and truly become a simplifier in your own life. So today's super thought of the day is this: what's the difference between a routine and a rut? Answer: when the routine no longer serves you, it's no longer bringing you your desired results. It's not getting you fired up in the morning or bringing you joy in your day-to-day life. It's a rut, and it needs shaking up. You know, I'm taking a bit of mental inventory of all aspects of my life right now, whether it's work or relationships, how I take care of myself and my fitness plan, the foods I eat, you name it. It's all up for discussion. And every now and again, I really like to zoom way out from my life and take stock. Because, you know, we get stuck because we're in too deep. We can't see the horizon. We're in the weeds, in the grind, and the everyday go. So in order to simplify your life, you need perspective. Pull yourself out of it. Think of your life as like one of those giant etch-a-sketches, and every now and again, you got to shake things up that need shaking. Create new thoughts, new belief systems, and pare down the nonsense and get back to basics. So here are three simple tips to change your current rut into a thriving routine today. Number one, at the gym. Change what you listen to and change your workout routine. What muscles are you training right now? Maybe there's, I don't know, a different class you could go check out and try. Try something new. Stretch new muscles in new, completely different ways. You know, if there's a machine that totally scares you at the gym, why not just tap a shoulder of one of the personal trainers and have them show you how to use it? You know, for me, when I see myself sweat, it means I'm doing the work. And when I'm at the gym and I'm in a haze of worry or overwhelm or just simply in autopilot mode, I'm not sweating. Aha, that's when I know I'm in a rut. So yeah, shake it up. I'm going to go try a HIIT class today. Pray for me that I actually survive, but I love it. Classes are really fun because it breaks you out of your normal everyday routine at the gym. And don't forget to change what you're listening to while at the gym. Change it up just for today. So if you're always listening to like pop music, maybe you switch over to some fast-pounding house music or flip altogether from music to a podcast that inspires you, like this one, or one of my favorites, Building a Story Brand by Donald Miller. See if that changes how you work out. Number two, at the office. Do you sit in the same exact spot the entire workday? Well, I challenge you to get up, get moving, and change your scenery every 2 hours today. So maybe you work at your desk for a couple hours, then move to a standing desk, or sit outside if the sun is shining, or head to the couch. See where and when you are most productive. Take inventory. See, this is really valuable information to see if simply changing your scenery like this helps your creative brain come up with new and innovative ideas. And if you're somebody who's got littles at home and you're juggling managing your work and your kiddos simultaneously, I pray you'll ask for help from your friends, your family, and your community. Girlfriend, you do not have to do it all alone. I repeat, you do not need to carry this all on your own. Even just getting 2 hours of help can make you incredibly more productive, help you feel more like yourself, and that life can be simpler. Number three, on your commute. If you find yourself commuting day in and day out and totally in autopilot mode here as well, I'm going to challenge you to think of new ways to mix it up. You know, I use the Waze app, and it helps you find faster routes to drive home, maybe new routes you've never even taken before. And since I'm in sort of a new city, it's exciting to me to actually learn, oh, that street connects with that street. Oh, I get it, right? Well, what about consider leaving 10 minutes earlier than you usually do so you can actually take a more leisurely pace and not feel like it's a manic dash at the end of the day? I am so guilty as charged of that. Sometimes I just go so fast and I push it at the last minute. So this is kind of a reminder for myself as well. Leave 10 minutes earlier. See what that feels like. change it up a bit. And again, change up what you're listening to on your commute. I find I oscillate between absolute silence to a podcast, to an audiobook on Audible, or even listening to my favorite radio station in Austin, Texas, 98.9 KUTX, which streams online. All the links are down below in the show notes, so check those out. But whatever works for you, bottom line is do something to wake yourself up during this time and rediscover this part of your day, which I've actually found can be a great source for inspiration once again. Side note, if you take a train to commute or a tram like I do in the mornings, consider meditating. It's incredible how that changes your rut into a routine. Now, if any of this thought of the day has inspired you, I encourage you also to snap a photo of you doing the thing and send it to me via Instagram. I'll be your virtual accountability buddy in your quest to simplify your life. And if you want to plug in with other simplifiers all over the world who listen to this podcast right alongside you, join our free online community, the Super Insiders. Here you'll find more tips, tricks, freebies, and more importantly, real life connection with others just like you who want to simplify their life. And it's all free, just our way to serve you guys. So go to thesimplifiers.com/super. That's thesimplifiers.com/super to join our free online community, or click the link in the show notes to join us on the inside. And as always, friends, keep things simple.